What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I want to show you a lifetime deal that's only $10, and it's called Lapse. This one lets you record your screen in time-lapse. So I don't think it's like a useful tool for working, but it's cool if you want to record in high-speed mode your workflow. That could be a use case for it. So in this video, what I'm going to do is I am actually going to edit one of my videos really quickly, but at the end of the day, you're gonna see how that time lapse is going to be recorded and shown at the end. So let me get started. Let me show you what the deal's about, and I'm gonna record how I edit one of my videos and record that in time lapse. So let's go check out the deal and check out Lapse right now. Okay, this is the deal that's going on right now. Like I said before, it's a $10 deal as of this video. It could go up later on. It's not my fault. You don't see this video soon. So don't forget to subscribe and get notified about these deals. That link will be provided in the description. It's an affiliate link. If you grab that link, it won't cost you a single cent more, but it gives me a small commission. Now, what you get for that is you get a lifetime access to the product. You get unlimited screen recordings, saved the videos in MP4, MKV, WebM, and all of those. And it can record 144p, which is super low quality. I wouldn't recommend it. Or up to 8K, which is pretty much crazy, right? But it gives you the option to record it. Now, the recordings don't go to a cloud. It doesn't upload. It actually doesn't even download. It records it and it renders inside of your desktop, all right? So just like as you would as a video editor, you edit your video and you render it inside of the desktop or the app, all right? It doesn't have to do anything with cloud. All right, so I already have it installed. This is Lapse and it's pretty much basic, the options. So you can select the export format. MP4 would be the most common one. The quality, you can select it to auto or select the quality that you want to use. In this case, I already tested it in auto, and what it does, it records the whole screen. This screen is 5K, I think it is. It's a MacBook 16-inch, but you can select the quality that you want to choose, all right? So maybe you want to go 1080p, 4K. These files are not large because remember, they are time-lapse. So they record pieces of the screen and then create the video, right? The speed frame, you can choose 12, 24, 30, or 60. Speed frame means frames per second. So that means that it's gonna have a image of each of these in a frame rate. You'd probably have to see a video to understand frame rate more clearly, but it's pretty simple. Reset settings if you want to keep it as default. Auto launch, if you wanted to launch in the beginning, I wouldn't recommend auto launch because basically you wouldn't use this every single time. It's basically for some cases. Do you want to show the timer? About lapse and quit lapse, all right? So that's the whole thing about lapse. Now, like I said, what I'm going to do is I'm gonna basically record a time lapse of me editing the video, and then I'm gonna show it at the end. If you don't want to see how I edit one of my videos, just go to this minute to see the time lapse video, all right? So let me start the time lapse right now. So I'm gonna start recording. And there we go, it just started, seconds. So let me drag in some files right here. Really quickly, so I'm gonna drag these two files. So basically, this would be my workflow of editing. I got two files. One is me recording DSLR, and the other one with the screen recording. And what I do first is first I find my intro.
Document 360 right now.
Okay, so that I know that's my intro, and what I'm gonna do is I come to the beginning, the end. Okay, so I have the intro and then I have the video. Next thing I do is I want to put these videos together. So the voice or me speaking is actually tied to the screen recording. So there's a lot of dead thing here. All right, let's make it smaller. Well, actually bigger. Okay, there we go. Get rid of this. Let's zoom. Again, the video's too big, but let me find it there. It's about there. I'm gonna zoom here, and I'm gonna tie my voice with the screen recording.
And in this case, we're gonna name it.
Okay.
FH.
So it's kind of okay there. So let me unzoom again. And now what I do is I remove the voice from the screen. I keep the DSLR one because that's where my microphone's connected, all right? And then I'll do, fix my chroma key, right? So right now you're seeing a green screen on the back. So I'll add my keying. In this case, I'm editing with Final Cut Pro, but most softwares have that available. Let me remove the desktop so you can see we have some whitish there because it's not the same green. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select this. I'm gonna go to my Chroma Key settings and I'm gonna choose the whole thing. All right, so now it's all clean. Now I'm gonna put my screen back and it's clean. So now I'm gonna position myself. All right, let's make myself put in the corner. This video has already been edited. I'm just playing around with this one. It's just for demo purposes. And then I'll find the beginning for this. So the video starts there. It's already tied. If I want to put these together, I'll compound them. All right. So when I chop off a video, so let's just say here, I had some dead space here. I'm not going to go through it, but I'll just say I'll remove that. And we continue. Hit space.
Okay, let's get started with the brand.
Like that. Let's just say I need to add my chroma key to this one. So here's a key here. Again, settings for this. I also have to fix the voice for it. So for example, I'll add my audio, which my audio effect, which is a Sennheiser. That's the microphone I'm using. I'll add up to all my clips. There we go. So
we recorded a 30%.
There we go. I'll add a background for the intro. I'll choose one of the backgrounds I have already. And I'll go for textures, industrial, zoom. There we go. We have a background there. And I can add some infographics, some tiles to it. So if I wanted to add something like this, there we go. And I'll reposition this. Now, what you're seeing right now is the demo of me editing. But this could be a workflow of the whole day. You record the whole thing and you make a short video, all right? So I'm not gonna edit what it says, it's just for
them. It's on your document 360. We recorded.
Okay, let's just say, you know what? I'm good to go with the beginning, the video, and everything's fine, and I'm good to go. So let me stop the time-lapse recording from lapse. It's processing, and it should ask me to save the file. Here it is. Not sure why it doesn't stick on the top, it should. And I'll just say doesn't let me edit that. Okay, let's keep that name, save it there. It's still processing. You'll see that on top from the lapse. Let me go into my desktop and it's still rendering. All right, so let's wait for that to get ready. Okay, so now it's ready and I want to show you what that workflow looks like. Okay, click play. It's 8 seconds. There you go. That is a recording of the time lapse of me editing, right? Now, this just was a quick edit. I have to do a whole lot to this video, but imagine doing a workflow of 2 hours, 3 hours, or those super complex editings where you add a lot of titles, music, soundtracks. It looks really awesome to see that time lapse. Or maybe you're working with a project management tool, or maybe you're doing just whatever you do on your desktop for work. You can record it. You can be recording the whole thing. In this case, I'm recording the screen with another software. I'm editing with Final Cut. Let me actually close it because my fans from the laptop are kicking in since I'm doing a whole lot of things on this. But you could find a use case for it if you find it interesting. For $10, having that deal, I think it's pretty interesting to record something like that that's really long and you want to show something cool. Now you might see these type of videos, for example, when you see someone on the road and you just see the whole time lapse really quickly of all the things, the events happening really quickly. It's used that way. Or maybe, a lot of situations. It's up to you what you want to use it for. But I mean, it could be interesting for some, it could be cool for others, and it could be pretty much useless for a lot of people. But for $10, you decide if it's something that you want to have because you might need it, or just to have something cool there. Well, there you go, guys. I hope you like this video of me just showing you what Lapse actually does really quick and easy. Again, if you guys want to grab the deal, that link will be in the description, which, like I mentioned before, it gives you a small commission that won't cost you a single cent more. What the deal costs, it's what it's gonna cost you there. All right, guys, I thank you all for watching. My name is George, this is Taskmaster, and I'll see you guys later.